Good morning to all of you. I am Neetu Gailon. I am working as assistant professor in St. Andrews Institute of Technology and Management, Gurgaon. I am taking biology subject from electrical department, and the topic which are covered in this lecture, these are the biotechnology in the sewage treatment. And this is my 22nd lecture. So today, the topic, that is the applications of biotechnology in the sewage treatment. And this is our fourth unit lecture. And in this unit, we have discussed about the applications of biotechnology in the agricultural field, then applications of biotechnology in the medical field, then enzyme technology, and there is the last topic which is related to the sewage treatment. So here, now we are going to start our topic, that is the biotechnology in the sewage treatment. Wastewater treatment is a process used to remove contaminants from wastewater or sewage and convert into an effluent that can be returned to the water cycle with minimum impact on the environment or directly reused. So in this topic, we are going to discuss about the how can we convert the sewage water in reuse, and then we can use in so many purposes of this water. So the environmental biotechnology is biotechnology that is applied to and used to study the natural environment. Here, firstly, we are discussing about the sewage treatment. So as we know that the large quantity of wastewater are generated every day in cities and the towns. So that is a major component of wastewater is a human excreta. This municipal wastewater is called sewage. Okay, so it contains large amount of organic matter and microbes, so many of which are the pathogenic. Okay, the treatment of wastewater depends upon the impurities present. The impurities present, these are the physical, chemical, and the biological, and accordingly the treatment given are physical, chemical, and biological treatment. It means just like the impurities, that is, there may be the physical impurity, chemical impurity, or the biological impurity. So the treatment is according to them. For the physical impurity, they can be removed by the physical treatment. Chemical impurities can be removed by the chemical treatment, and the biological impurities removed by the biological treatment. So here, this is the sewage treatment, and we can see here the physical treatment, chemical treatment, and biological treatment. So in the physical treatment, there is the, we can remove the large suspended and the floating matter. In short, we can say that in the physical treatment, there are the removal of large and suspended and the floating matters. Okay. And in the chemical treatment, so there are the removal of the dissolved chemicals. And third one is the biological treatment. Here, we can remove the dissolved organic chemicals. So here, according to the sewage treatment, there are the physical treatment, chemical treatment, and biological treatment. And we can remove the suspended impurities, the suspended and the floating matter by the physical treatment, dissolved chemicals by the chemical treatment, and the dissolved organic chemicals, these are removed by the biological treatment. So treatment of water, or we can say that is a wastewater. So treatment of wastewater is done by the heterotrophic microbes, okay, naturally present in the sewage. So this treatment is carried out two or three stages. Here we can say these are the three stages. So there, these three stages are the three stages of the treatment. So they are the primary stage, secondary stage, and then is the tertiary stage. So in this topic, we are going to study the primary and the secondary treatment in detail. So here, firstly, this is the primary treatment. And in the primary treatment, it means this is only the physical separation to remove solid matter, or if effluent is allowed to settle for a few hours. Or we can say in the primary treatment, it means that here this is the screening also, okay, and by which we can remove the floating matters and the leaves particles and the cloth particles. So these are the removed by the screening process. So here the first is the primary treatment. So these treatment steps basically involve physical removal of particles. So they are the large and the small, and from the sewage through there are the filtration and the sedimentation. Okay, and the second one is the second treatment is the organic and nutrient load is decreased by microbial activity up to 95% so that the effluent is of a quality to be able to go into rivers. So it may be aerobic and anaerobic treatment. Okay, and the third type of the treatment is the tertiary treatment. This is complete treatment, but it is very expensive and not used so much. So now come to the here. These are the three steps in which we can we know about the treatment. Those are the primary treatment, secondary treatment, and the tertiary treatment. So here now come to the primary treatment in detail. So here. Primary treatment, this is a physical process. Wastewater flow is slowed down and suspended solids settle to the bottom of gravity. We know the heavy particles are settled down in the bottom of the tank or tank and by the gravitational force. Okay, so here the waste material that settles is called sludge or biosolids, and all solids that settle form the primary sludge and the supernatant form the effluent. So the effluent from the primary settling tank is taken for secondary treatment. So here the first treatment is complete and now goes to the second treatment. And before going to the second treatment, here we want to discuss about the some points which are related to the primary treatment. They are the when we and as we know that the in this primary treatment there are the physical removal of the particles. They are the large and the small from the sewage through filtration and the sedimentation. So these are removed in the stages. Initially, that is the floating debris is removed by the sequential filtration. Then the second one is the soil and the small pebbles. These are called the grit. These are removed by the sedimentation, and all solids that settle from the primary sludge and the supernatant forms are effluent. So the effluent form from the primary settling tank is taken for the secondary treatment. Okay, so this is the primary treatment. Now come to the secondary treatment. Here, this is a secondary treatment, or we can say the secondary treatment is also called the biological treatment also. Okay, so the secondary treatment, as we know that it is called the biological process, or to utilize the bacteria and the algae to metabolize organic matters in the wastewater. So here we use the bacteria and the algae to metabolize the organic matter. So now, when the primary wastewater mixed with the bacteria rich, it is activated. and cellulose and air or oxygen is pumped into the mixture. Clear? So both aerobic and anaerobic bacteria may exist. Promoter bacteria, growth and decomposition of organic matter. Okay, and here there the BOD. BOD means biochemical oxygen demand. It removal is the approximately it is 85%. Okay. And the microbial removal by the activated cellulose, this is 80 to 99% removal of bacteria and 90 to 99% is the removal of viruses. Okay, so once the BOD, it means the biological oxygen demand of sewage or wastewater is reduced significantly. The effluent is then passed into the settling tank where the bacterial flocks are allowed to sediment. So this sediment is called the activated cellulose. Okay, so now this is important that what is the activated cellulose. Okay, so a small part of the activated cellulose is pumped back into the aeration tank to serve as the inoculum. Okay, then the remaining major part of the cellulose is pumped. The remaining major part of the cellulose is pumped into large tank is called the anaerobic cellulose digesters. Here, so we know that the small part of the activated cellulose is pumped back into the aeration tank, so serve as the inoculum, and the remaining major part of the cellulose is pumped into large tank, is called anaerobic cellulose digesters. So here, other kind of bacteria which grow anaerobically digest the bacteria and the fungi in the cellulose. So during this digestion, bacteria produce a mixture of gases such as the methane, hydrogen sulfide, and carbon dioxide. So these gases form biogas and can be used as a source of energy. Okay, so this is the process as it is inflammable. Here the effluent from the secondary treatment plant is generally released into natural water bodies like the river and the stream also. So here I repeat one more time that what is the sewage treatment plant, and you have to remember this topic. So the number and the unit of type of units selected, it depends upon the strength of the wastewater. If the municipal wastewater is having high BOD, it means the biological oxygen demand, and almost all units are required. In some case of wastewater is weak, and then we can have recycling system, but all units are provided. So recycling system is used for increasing the BOD and SS removal in the biological treatment. Okay, and the units operations in wastewater treatment. So as we discussed above, in the above treatment plant, the treatment takes place in the three stages. Okay, so firstly is the primary treatment. Okay, so here the consisting of the screening and the grit removal. Then the primary treatment, here the consisting of the primary sedimentation tank, and the secondary treatment, so consisting of the trickling filter and the secondary sedimentation tank and the disinfection unit. So you have to learn that the units which are operations in the wastewater treatment. I repeat again, the preliminary treatment, it consisting of the screening and the grit removal. Then the primary treatment, the consisting of primary sedimentation tank, and the secondary treatment, the consisting of trickling filter and secondary sedimentation tank and disinfection unit. Okay. Now the these are the sewage treatment. As we know, the biological treatment is fully utilize the microbes, microorganism for the treatment of the wastewater. So depending upon the type of microbes use the biological treatment is classified as they may be the as we know that is the anaerobic treatment using the aerobic organism. So the example of the treatment unit are activated sludge plant, trickling filter, rotating biological contractors, and oxidation ponds, etc. And for the anaerobic treatment, so anaerobic treatment use the aerobic microbes. The example of anaerobic treatment units are the sludge disasters, etc. Okay, so these are the sewage treatment. Here, now when that treatment is complete, or we can say that the treatment is done, so then the effluent back to stream after, okay, and there are the final carbon filtration, and the second one is the chlorination or the dechlorination. Okay, and then the sludge, it is very nutrient rich. And the sludge that is very nutrient rich and applied directly to land as fertilizer, and that is a good fuel after the drying, and the composites also. So here the very important part is the activated sludge process. So now I want to explain the activated sludge process. Again, it is the most versatile biological oxidation process employed for the treatment of wastewater contained dissolved solids, colloids, porous solid, and the organic matter. The sewage from sedimentation tank enter into the aeration tank. Here the 20-30% of the activated sludge is mixed, and the mixture is aerated and mixed in the tank for about the 4 to 8 hours. So the efficient aeration for 3 to 6 hours is occupied for sludge, while for the industrial waste 6 to 24 hours so of the aeration is required. The microorganism oxide, organic matter, in the presence of abundant quantity of oxygen in the aeration tank, the sewage is allowed to settle in the secondary sedimentation tank. So they are the process by which we can treat the sewage, at the end of the topic we are going to the conclusion that the water is one of the most important source on earth. Okay, and it is known as a universal solvent. We must not waste the water. The wastewater that we obtain from our daily purpose and from industries must be treated in treatment system in order to reduce pollution. Okay, or our government must provide the facilities and infrastructure to avoid water pollution and manage worse water. Okay, so this is the conclusion also. And now to the wastewater treatment, and we know that we should know that the how microbes plays a major role in treating the millions of the gallon of water, wastewater, every day across the globe. So this methodology has been practiced for more than a century now in almost all parts of the world. So till date, no man-made technology has been able to revive the microbial treatment of seaways. Okay, the Ministry of the Environment and the Forest has initiated Ganga Action Plan and the Yamuna Action Plan to save these major rivers of our country from pollution. Okay, so under these plans, it is proposed to build a large number of the sewage treatment plants so that only treated sewage can be discharged in the river. Okay, so this is the wastewater treatment. Or it is a sewage treatment and the role of the microbes or the biotechnology in this treatment. So now I complete my lecture. For query, can contact me. Thank you.